Now that we've billed the client for our progress in the job, it's time to record receiving payments for those invoices. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. It's nice to finally receive payment for some of the work that we've done for the job that we made a contract for. The payment schedule is usually part of the contract. Usually the required periodic payments are based on an amount of work done and invoiced to the client. The down payment, which is sometimes called the job deposit, is a payment received in advance of work done on the job, and we will learn about this type of payment in the next video. That is the video that follows this one. In this video, we will assume that all payments are for the existing invoices and immediately deposited into the bank account. When we receive payment for an open invoice, the most important report that will help you manage the payments you receive from clients is the open invoice report. It shows the open or unpaid amount of each invoice. It would also show any payments you received that were not yet applied to a specific invoice. Once the payments have been applied to an invoice, both the invoice and the payment will be removed from the open invoice report. Now, before we get to the example, let's take a look at what the open invoice report looks like right now. If you don't have it in front of you, you can click Reports, click on the Custom Report tab, and then click Open Invoice. And you can see these are the two invoices that we created for the Hanson Place job, and they're waiting to be paid. For example, let's imagine on January 15th, we received check number 61 for $1,000 from Brown Company for the Hanson Place job. Well, how would we record that and what would the results be? Well, in order to record receiving payment, we would click the new plus sign on the top left and go down to where it says receive payment, the second choice down in the leftmost column. When we click receive payment, it simply asks us for the information about the payment. So January 15th, so we'll put January 15th, and we'll put Brown Company specifically for the Hanson Place job, and the payment method is check, and the check number is check 61, and it was deposited directly into the cash and bank account. Now watch what happens when we put in the field for the amount received. After you type it in, go to the left side of your keyboard and push the tab key. Notice QuickBooks will assume that it is the oldest invoice that the $1,000 should be applied to, and it will automatically place the check mark on the oldest one. Since the oldest one is more than $1,000, that means that this invoice, invoice number 1001, will still be open. And therefore, it will still be on the open invoice report, but it will be down to the remaining balance of $350. When we click, well, you could click Save and Close and then look at your open invoice. Now notice, originally, the January 3rd invoice was $1,350. But since we just applied a $1,000 payment to it, the amount that remains open is only $350 and the other one is still completely unpaid. Now, watch what happens when we do our second example. Imagine on January 20, we receive check number 74 for $1,000 from Brown Company, also for the Hanson Place job. Now, before we record this, can you predict what the numbers will be? Well, if the invoices are applied in date order, that means the $1,000 will completely pay off the first invoice, and the remaining $650 will decrease the second invoice. Let's take a look at what will happen in the Receive Payments window. Click the plus sign in the top left for a new transaction. In the Customer column, go down to Receive Payment and click. Now, again, this is not only from Brown Company, but it is specifically for the Hanson Place job. The date is January 20, and the payment method again is check. It's check number 74, and it's deposited directly into the bank. Now, we're going to put in another $1,000 in the amount received box. Push tab, and after you push tab, notice it applies 350 out of the 1,000 to the oldest one. Therefore, $650 remain to be applied to the second oldest one, and that's exactly how the receive payment window will behave. So when we click save and close, the first invoice will be completely paid, and the second invoice will decrease by 650, and there should only be 700 remaining on the open invoice report. Save and close, and now you can see the first invoice for January 3rd was gone, and the second invoice is still open in the amount of $700.